Oh, hi, I would like some help.
What do you want?
Well, I was wondering if I could have some Dove products, please.
Well, how about something else first?
Ooh, you got a better option for me?
Well, how about you consider your part in the Barbie crisis of the 1990s first?
Wait, the what?
You know, the Barbie crisis of the 1990s? You must have been taught that by your sister, right?
Well, I don't know what you're talking about. I was born in 2005, and I have no fucking idea what the Barbie crisis was.
Well, how about we talk about something different?
Yeah, like a product I can get so I can wash.
Shut the fuck up about getting soap! You have no idea how much damage shows in the past have caused me.
I hate to break it to you, but you, how old are you again?
Good to know. I am a 22-year-old woman whose self-esteem was almost destroyed by the garbage that was on television when I was 8.
What? You mean the marvelous misadventures of Flapjack?
What the fuck are you even talking about? I was more focusing on shows aimed for girls that taught little girls terrible life lessons that is leading to the increased suicide rates among girls everywhere.
Jesus Christ, I just wanted some damn soap.
How about you just listen to me as I tell you how Sailor Moon grew me as a child to hate myself and date abusers?
How about I fuck out of there so I don't have to listen to your shit?
Fine, get lost. But don't come back when your daughter is on suicide watch because of Sailor Moon.
I don't have a daughter. I'm 18. Now I know why everyone who works at Dove is a woke anthologist. You know, sometimes you look at a person's worst qualities and hope they grow out of it. That they would change their bad parts to become something better. And in the past, it normally worked. But tell that to a modern female, and you'll be spending the next hour of your life being taught how oppressive the patriarchy, or what little is left of it, is. And no group embodies that persona than the body positivity movement. Now, let me get this straight, because I know some of you are already typing hate comments. Body positivity, in theory, is not as bad as you think. If you ask me, body positivity was meant for people with disabilities, scars, deformities, etc. I think we can all accept that. But unfortunately, the movement has mostly been hijacked by the fat acceptance movement. A group that, while saying that yes, fat shaming is bad, is incredibly flawed as it encourages people to grow into obesity and the negative effect it has on the body. Such effects include bad body, poor muscles, poor digestion, low stamina,
diabetes,
death, and skin conditions which are so shocking you might as well head to the gym every day and hope you don't get anything like this. And there is one company that has recently hopped on this trend. Well, by that I mean it was a year ago. But I found a video they made later down the line which may or may not contain the same messages but certainly contains the same idea of what the body positivity movement has been saying over the past year. So yeah. In case you don't know, the company I am referring to is Dove, a personal care brand founded in 1957. Now, of course, Dove has fallen into controversies over the years, but those are more related to racism. And sure, we have some body positive activists saying that thinness is rude and racism, but we are not gonna do that because that is a different topic entirely. What we're actually going to talk about are three Dove videos I would like to bring up that attempt to bring this body positive message around. So let's start off with the first one. So first off, we like to start off with this video that isn't uploaded by Dove, but does have them in the video. The video itself was uploaded by Lola Mullen Love on October 3rd, 2022. So let's have a look and see what all the fuss is about. Oh, hi everyone. In case you haven't noticed, this is my new set for reacting to videos. It'll come in handy in the future, but for now, let's go and react to this one. And trust me, it will not be a pleasant watch.
Había dos personajes, mujeres, nada más. Los dos eran dos personajes super sexualizados. Y nada, eran las dos opciones que tenía para elegir.
Wait, what game are you referring again? The Last of Us Part 2? Because I can't name a video game with only two female characters that are both overly sexualized. There might be one, but I can't find one and don't care to give a shit. So let's continue on with the video. Oh, wait! It's just a screen saying that 2 out of 3 female gamers in the UK say there's a lack of representation in video games. Dove, you do realize this video was made in 2022, not 1982, because God forbid there were only a handful of them in 1982, but I digress.
You were not there. You don't exist. The things are not made for you.
Then find a different game to play with better representation rather than a Japanese cleavage rag you bought from the discount store. Oh wait, you're disabled. So anyway, there's this game called the Pegasus Dream Tour that is perfect for you.
I don't look like that. Not everyone looks like that.
No shit, Sherlock. And that's the point. Video games are not a reflection of you. And if they were, they'd have personality features that you can choose. But besides, why the hell would you not sit down and play Super Mario 3D World as Princess Peach? Or any other Peach games? Or even the movie?
We should really show everybody that who we really are as people, and we should all, like, have a chance.
Oh, sorry. I know your language isn't exactly perfect because of your Down syndrome. But why not enter the games industry and create one yourself? At least that's what I think you should do. But let's see what Dove is saying. At Dove, we want to change that. Dove, I know you're partnering up with Unreal Engine here, but you are a personal care company, not a game developer. Let the SJW game makers do their job and go back to selling body washes.
A character that looks like me in a video game and be like, yo, this baby's fire.
Of course it didn't get into a video game, at least to my knowledge that is, and I doubt it ever will.
There are thousands of skins available to choose from. But finally, one that looks like mine.
I don't know about you, but this looks like the most PS2 graphic thing I've seen since the sequel to Megamind, which came out after this ad.
Oh, I look so badass.
Yeah, that's because you have low standards. And oh, what's this? We created avatars inspired by a real woman to show what representation in games would look like. Well, clearly you only used women with disabilities or something along the lines like that. And look, Duff, I know you're trying to give more representation to people with physical disabilities, but most women don't have disabilities. And though the stats are hard to determine, it's around 5 to 20%.
It's not only about self-esteem, it's about what you can or cannot do with your life.
Well, it doesn't take a genius to find out what you could be doing to improve your life, but I digress.
We are different.
It's beautiful, I think it's a dream.
Well, yeah, there is no game with your exact character, but there is Pegasus Dream Tour. But I guess Duff was too busy saying this to know that this game exists. And we're now partnering with Unreal Engine and Women in Games to drive more diversity in gaming. Yeah, as stupid as that company name, Women in Gaming, may sound, it is a real company. Also, what's this drive more diversity in gaming bullshit? It's already been done before, whether it's good or not.
Is there anything more powerful than being a legend?
Being a president of a first world country with nuclear arms?
Yes, being real.
My entire brain just shut down. Being real is more powerful than being a legend. I know it's for being in video games, but the writing is so poor, I actually think that she said that being real is more powerful than being a legend in a video game. Because if that is the case, then you are real! In the real world, for fuck's sake!
We are unique, beautiful, and brave, and that we should be able to play the game.
What? The video game is unplayable unless the character looks like you? Do you even know what you're fucking saying? Because if that were true, then every white female would be legally allowed to burn their copy of Spider-Man 2. And to top it off, they say the video title of Let's Make Virtual Beauty Real, or something down the lines like that. Well, if you want to do that, then I have to say that I have a Wii, so good luck into that. Cause Nintendo certainly won't. Well, that was a very fishy trip, wasn't it? Anyways, so let's look at the description of the video. I know I should have done this before, but I am a lazy motherfucker, so let's jump to it.
A study by Dove together with Women in Games shows that 60% of girls and 62% of women are not represented in video games.
Wait, but in the video you said 2/3. That's like 66%. 60% is more like 3/5. and 62 out of 100 is like 31 out of 50. So your stats make no sense.
Oh, by the way,
I did some of my own research and the true numbers are like 49%. Sure, it's still not good, but it's less than half, which shows that more females feel more represented in today's climate than, you know, what your video claims. Oh, by the way, that was a study that came out 12 days after the video was uploaded to YouTube. Your poor study led to a better research, which ended up producing better results. And yes, there is another study from the UK saying that 60% of female gamers in the UK felt that female characters' body types often portray unrealistic beauty standards, but I'm not gonna believe it because I sincerely believe their minds are stuck in 2002. Oh, they also have support from Epic Games. So remind me when these characters enter Fortnite. But that is just add one, because there is another. Well, actually two more, but here is the best known example.
Millions of girls will grow up thinking that this is the right way to act. That they can never be anything more than vacuous ninnies whose only goal is to look fat!
If I'm to be fully honest with myself, I bet you all skipped this segment because of the video's notoriety. Yes, this is the RVB, Cynthia's Battle video, uploaded May 11th, 2023 by Lola Mullenlow, again. This one took the internet on fire, in the wrong direction. So let's have a look at the video. So the video starts with none other than Cynthia, our main character, defeating a villain for some sort of game or something. We then cut to a PNG screen proving that this game is in development. She waves to the villain, who is actually just an actor, goodbye, and heads to her dressing room. We see a bunch of posters proving that she's been doing this for like, you know, some time actually. She then goes to the mirror, looks at herself before taking off her armor, revealing her true colors. She then goes to relax, only to be needed for some lunch break or promotional shoot or something, I don't know. She then looks in the mirror, again, and after looking at her video game self, looks to the audience as if to say, yeah, I'm paid a lot of money for this. She then decides to grab the fat sword, ironic, before exiting the room for some sort of body positive photo shoot. And the dove messages come on. 74% of girls feel underrepresented in video games. Hey, wait a minute, last time you said it was 66% of females were underrepresented in video games. Now you're saying 74%. That's not too bad. That's close to 3/4! How inconsistent are you that you change your percentage higher so you think that I am the villain here? Well, don't look at me. I'm a Gen Z person and I have nothing to do with it. And yes, they continue to talk that they partner up with both companies and oh look, it's not a Photoshop, it was an advertisement for the game's body positive mode. Yeah, quite ironic that the game developers in the story are shockingly more realistic in an ad that is meant to say that game developers hate obese people. But honestly, I find it to be the least infuriating of the ads, but it still leaves a bitter taste in my mouth. Okay, enough blabbering. Let's go to the description.
This is the story of Cynthia, a video game character who, after defeating the last enemy, finds herself facing one much more important battle.
Really? I just saw the ad and I think she's probably done this multiple times before. But continuing on, they continue to show the stats that are not equal in the video with over... Hang on a sec. With over 1/3 of young girls' self-esteem being negatively impacted by the current lack of diversity.
What?
To quote Diesel Patches here.
Holy shit, go outside.
I have no idea how you got this info. It certainly wasn't themselves because they didn't provide much evidence for mass research. And despite the fact that Lizzo existed until she recently didn't, the percentage of girls who reported feeling self-confident dropped by like 13% between 2017 and 2023. I have no idea how a society that favors women can still have a decrease in body confidence for girls in the year 2023. So what are they supposed to do? Ban thin women from existing? But I'm getting ahead of myself. So what is the percentage of women wishing for more inclusivity in video game characters? Like 74%. I tried to prove them wrong, but all the sites are secondhand sources from them, including this highlight.
The gaming industry still reflects the narrow beauty standards of the Lara Croft era, negatively affecting female players' self-esteem and making them feel underrepresented.
Can we just give every little girl a copy of Princess Peach Showtime for their birthday or Christmas? Maybe then the media might shut themselves up. Oh, by the way, it's based on the story of Cynthia Dalama, one of the girls from the last video and whose account I am not showing here because I am not that villainous. And also because Doug mentioned her in the description. So yeah. Not a good idea to give their identity away to everyone, Dove. Now, you might be wondering why I'm late to the party. Why I decided to make this video now and not, you know, a year ago. Well, Dove made a new ad that kind of pushed me to the limits where I just had to make this video to avoid misinformation.
Dude, Kenny, enough about Tammy's knockers. You sound like a white male trying to reestablish the patriarchy.
Okay, what video am I talking about? I'm talking about Hard Knocks, a Dove big game film. A 30-second ad released on February 3rd of this year, 2024, on Dove's main account. Now, Dove may have avoided that mistake for the previous two videos by having other channels upload the videos for them. This video is all on them. So let's have a look. So we start off with a bunch of clips of girls screwing up while playing sports. It's basically the stuff you would see in a mishap video. Of course, fuck-ups are rare in sports, and Dove's noticed. The knocks don't stop girls playing sport. Of course, it's not the 1950s anymore. But what does, low body confidence does?
Well, I know that's not true.
So, after we get a look at a girl, we get another message telling us to keep them in the game and join their body confidence sports program. Oh, and it ends with the girl running near the pool and not slipping. Hey. I just had to point out that minor detail. Now, moving on to the description. They say that
45% of girls are quitting sports, and low body confidence is the number one reason why.
Okay. Let's have a look at this piece by piece. First of all, the stat that girls stop playing sports by 14 is sort of true. But the true peak is around about 15, with half. So while the first one may or may not be true, the second is the one where I had to swear they made this while they were on drugs. Because they say that body confidence is the number one reason why, when this is far from the truth. A study from YouthSense stated that 48% of girls quit sports to have more time to study. I could just end it here, but here is a list from the Women's Sports Foundation that said the 6 reasons why most girls drop out of sports are lack of access, safety and transportation issues, social stigma, decreased quality of experience, cost, and lack of positive role models. Tell that one to the Matildas. Another source, womeninsport.com, said that 68% of girls quit sports due to a fear of being judged by others, which is just social anxiety disorder. They also state that 61% quit because of a lack of confidence, not body confidence, general confidence. And yes, they do say that body image and puberty are also significant factors, but they say that 78% say that they avoid sports when they are having their period. I can understand this because parents are often painful to go through and getting one in the middle of a sports game is never a good thing. And yes, body image might be a reason, but it's certainly not the number one reason. Because here's the thing, if you're overweight, sports are a good way of losing weight. Sure, it might not get immediate results, but things take time, you know? You just gotta take it slow to look healthy. So saying that you can't do sport because of body image is sort of stupid when you realize it's the very thing that can help you lose weight. Which is the number one reason why I hate this video. Because it ignores the research done by others who actually know how to research shit.
Oh, I'm certainly glad I'm home. I wouldn't want to go through that again.
So, in the end, Dove has attempted to try and make themselves look good by trying to put real beauty in video games and lie about sports and body confidence. And because of that, all 3 videos have a dislike ratio of over 80%. An astonishing backfire on their part that proves that people just apolitical shit. But it wasn't just shit. Sure, they did claim that they did do research, but the research was either flawed, had no evidence, or were complete lies. And if the Hard Knocks video is something, it proves that Dove has learned absolutely nothing from their previous two ads, and instead thinks that self-esteem issues are the biggest problem. And sure, it might be a problem, but it isn't the main problem. That would be financial, bored, some kids don't like pressure as a sport becomes more competitive, and the lack of developing talent. So here's a hot tip, Dog. Stop making up your own stats and do some real fucking research for once. Thanks for watching!
Now, fuck off!